Okay, the topic for today is brainy choices. Are they greedy or fair? Let's find out. So, we are the result of our choices. Bad choices leads to bad outcomes. The fact that 1.3 billion people worldwide live in poverty is clearly the result of bad decision making. If we want to improve the living conditions for everyone, we need to make more brainy decisions. And that leads us to our first question. Are brainy decisions greedy or fair? So, the ultimatum game is a perfect experimental paradigm to study fairness and social punishment. So, in this game, two players have to agree upon how to split a fixed sum of money between themselves. So one player suggests to another, like, you get 50 and I take 50. And the responder can choose to either accept or reject this offer. If the player chooses to accept the offer, it means that the split will be realized. However, if the receiver chooses to reject the offer, neither of the two will get any money. So if someone chooses to reject an offer, it means that he pays a price to punish the proposer. And this is also a way to implement fairness, saying that if you're not nice to me, I'm not going to be nice to you. So here on your left side, you see the example of a fair proposal. So here, the proposer says, I got 100 kroners, I will give you 50, and I will take 50 for myself. And fair proposals like these are accepted 100% of the time. So on your right side, you see the example of an unfair proposal. So in this case, the proposer says, I got 100 kroner, I will give you 20, and I will take 80 for myself. These type of unfair offers are rejected 50% of the time. And as we heard before, according to economic theory, one should always accept all monetary offers because we have to maximize our profit. I mean, in the end, some money is more than none, right? But this is not the kind of rational brainy behavior we see in everyday life. Why is that? Well, this is actually due to that we have a built-in mechanism in our brains that prevents us from being too greedy. So let's take a look what actually happens in the brain when people play the ultimatum game. So in this particular study, I and my colleagues were the first to show that amygdala, that you can see here, a structure very important for emotional processing, was involved in the neural processing of unfairness and also in the rejection of an unfair proposal. And this is actually very interesting because amygdala is a very old brain structure and it's part of our reptile brain. So that means that the mechanism of fairness and to implement justice has been around for quite a while. Another part of our study was to see what happens if we suppress the amygdala activity. Can we change our subject's behavior by knocking out amygdala? So in order to accomplish this, we gave our subjects an anxiolytic drug because these drugs are known to actually suppress the amygdala activity. And what happened? Well, when there was basically no amygdala signal, our subjects accepted these unfair proposals to a much greater extent than the group that just got the placebo treatment. So this means that when we actually gave our subjects an anxiolytic drug, we made them more greedy. Interestingly, we did not change their perception of unfairness. That remained the same, so they could tell what was fair and unfair. We only changed their behavior. So another interesting thing is actually happening in the brain when we act fairly to others. So in one of their studies, Tricomi et al. Investigated what happens when rich and poor people transfer money between themselves. So to find out, they divided their subjects into two groups. One group was given $80, and these people were considered to be the rich people. Another group of subjects were just given $30, and this group of people was considered to be the poor people in this study. And then the task was to basically transfer money between themselves. So what happened? Well, as you can see here, when a rich person gave money to a poor person, their striatum, the reward center of the brain, got activated. So they felt good about giving some of their money to poor people. But when they got money from someone who was poor, it didn't feel as good. So there were basically no signal of reward in the brain when they had to take money from someone poor. So if we look what happened in the poor subjects, the opposite pattern was actually observed. So as you can see here, when a poor person got money from a rich person, their striatum got activated. That was a signal of reward in their brain. But when they had to give money to someone who was rich, then there was no sign of reward. So this is kind of like the Robin Hood in our brain, you know? We take from the rich and we give to the poor. And that's kind of what our brain is telling us. Because this kind of striatal activity kind of shows us that when resources are equally distributed, the brains of both parties signals reward. So this is our brain's way of telling us that sharing is good, that we actually should distribute our resources equally. So hippies, please take notes. So what actually happens if we zoom out a bit, and what happens when we follow the signals of amygdala and striatum? So research has shown that when we actually distribute our resources equally, it leads to great benefits. Because living in a society where resources are equally distributed and where the discrepancy between rich and poor people is very, very small, that leads to a healthier and a better educated population. So there are lots of benefits. So, usually people tell you to follow your heart, whatever you do. But when it comes to fairness, my message is follow your amygdala. Thank you very much.